Hi friends, welcome to the YouTube channel Manohar Papasani. In this video, I am going to explain about constants in Python. I hope you are ready for that. In the previous video, we had discussed about variables and keywords. But now we are going to discuss about constants, types of constants we have in Python. I hope you are ready for that. Let me just show you that. So generally in Python, we are going to discuss about the basic constants in this video. Let's start about that. The first one, when I talk about constants, we have the following constants in Python. First one, string, that is string constants. Number two, numeric constants. And then after this, we are going to discuss about, so friends, numeric constants, then Boolean constants, and then we have one more, complex numbers. So all this is there in, or you can say complex constants, anything is fine for us. These are the basic constants which we have in Python. String constants, the basic constants. Of course, we'll talk more about a few more other constants like tuple, list, all that. But before going to discuss about that, let's get a deeper idea about these constants for string, numeric, Boolean, and complex numbers. Are you ready for this now? Let's start with this now. String constants. So what is a string constant? Generally, you know, what is a string? String is simple, friends. Group of characters enclosed in double quotes or single quote. That is string in Python. Group of characters enclosed in double quotes or single quotes. I can simplify this. Anything in double quotes, anything in single quote is string in Python. Might be it is a little different in other programming languages. But in Python, anything in double quotes or anything in single quotes is a string. For example, let me just give you a small example. So, examples are like this. But before that, I'll just write this. Anything in double quote. What quote, friends? Double quote or single quote. What is that? Single quote is a string. Is a string in Python. I hope this is clear to all of you. Next, after this, examples. Let us see a few examples here. First one, I'll take what is that? Something like Mano in single quotes. This is what? A string. Also, I'll take the same in double quotes. That is also a string. So, anything in single quote or anything in double quote is a string, friends. I hope this is clear for all of you, right? So got clarity on this? Anything in single quote or double quote. So that's all, friends. This is about string constant. Again, we can declare this constants. Of course, constants means values or literals or data. You can call with any name. So generally, when somebody asks you, so data, when somebody tell you data or literals or constants or values, anything is same. Okay. So what is that? Data or values or constants or literals, anything is what is that, friends? Constant. You can call with any of these four names. Don't get confused. Now that's fine, we understood about string constant. Now so now the question is, in how many ways we can represent string constant? Let me just explain. We can represent string constant in two ways in Python. How? So let's see that we can represent a string constant in two ways in Python. How do you do that? It's very simple. First one is single line string. What is that? Single line string. That is one thing. Second one, multi-line string. What is that? Multi-line string. So in this way we can declare string in two ways, a single line string and multi line strings. I hope this is clear for all of you. Do you understand this, friends? Got clarity on this? So, friends, what is single line and what is multi line? Let's look at this now. Let's talk about single line here. When you talk about single line string, it's very simple, right? You have the answer in that name itself. What is that? Single line. A string terminated in a single line. String declared in single line is nothing but single line string. For example, str equal to in something. My name is Manohar, something like this. And this is single line string in Python. I hope this is clear now. Suppose you want to go for multi-line string. You want to write, declare multiple lines with a string. You want to initialize multiple lines as your value. Then we can do that in a simple way. How do you do that? Let me explain that. Let me just show you. This is single line, of course. If you want to write the same thing in multiple lines, we can do that like this. str equal to my slash, then what is that? And name slash p slash, and then what is that? P slash, then what is that? Manohar, something like this, and the quotes, double quotes. And then you can print it if you want. Yeah, I hope you know how to print this. It's a simple processor. So just you need to just say print off, what is that? Str in the command prompt. Is this fine for all of you friends? That's it. For clarity on this, that's the basic idea how to represent single line and multi-line. Of course, there is one more way apart from these two. That is, you can use triple quotes for multi-line. What quotes are? Triple quotes. We had seen double quotes. We had seen single quote. Even we can use triple quotes to represent a string in Python. I hope you are clear for that. You are ready for that. Let me just show you. You can do something like this. Str equal to I love teaching. I'm just writing like this. That I'm just going to split it into three lines. I love, the other one is, what is that? Teaching. You don't need slash here, but you need triple quotes. Put one more quote here. So here also triple quote, and here also remove this double quote. This is triple quote. Is it simple, right? So that's all, friends. This is how you can declare a single line string and multi-line strings. The last two discuss about the multiple lines, and the first one discuss about single line. If you want, I'll just show you how to display them from the command prompt. Let me just show you here, not this one. This is not Python console. Let me open a Python console. Now you can see str equal to something like my name is Manohar. You can see this, and I am just trying to print this, print of str, and I print, you get that in single line. Similarly, I can split this value into multiple lines and display it. Let me show you the second one. It's str equal to again my slash, and if I want I can split name slash, then what is that, is slash, then what is that, Manohar, something like this, and double quotes, then press enter, then print, what is that, str, then you can see my name is Manohar. You got that there, right? So I can split it into multiple lines. Might be you ask me a question, it's not showing the result in multiple lines. When you split with slash, again it will bring back those values to the same line. But if you want that as fixed, then you have to use triple quotes. What quotes are? Triple quotes. Let me show you. My str equal to triple quote. Again, what is that? My name is, then what is that? Manohar. That's it. Again, triple quote, enter. Then now you print that str. Then you can see this now. What is that? You got it in different lines, right? If you want to, it to be displayed in line by line, you know, in multiple lines, then use triple quote. If you want to split into multiple lines, but you want to display in the same line, if you want the output to be in the same line, then you have to use slash with double quote or single quote, anything is fine. Otherwise, if you want everything in the same line, just what is that? You need to just put that all the tokens in the, all the words in the same line, just in double quote or single quote. I hope this should give you clarity. Are you clear with that now? So that's it, my dear friends. Now, that is the idea about string constants. And how do you represent string? Is this clear to all of you? No? So that's all, friends. Now we have to talk about numeric constants. Generally, in any programming, we have two types of numeric constants. Let's talk about that. So what is that? So the first one is integer. When you talk about numeric constants, it's so simple. So we have two types of numeric constants, friends. So that is integer constants. Then the other one is a floating point constants. What constants are? Floating point constants. Are you following this, friends? We have two types of numeric constants in Python, integer and floating point. What is an integer? That's so simple. Integer means number without fraction. That's very simple. What is that? It is a number without fraction. That's what we call integer is. Suppose, for example, all this 10, 20, all these are integers. And we can represent integers in two ways. As int implicitly, generally by default, everything is in 10, 20 like that. Otherwise, this is having a limited number. This is a limited number. Suppose you ask me, I want unlimited integer. Then you have to declare it as long. So long means unlimited implicitly, because we don't have explicit data types in Python. I hope this is clear now. So by default, we can represent integers in two ways, either as int type or as either as long. Int is limited number. You have some limited digits. You don't have more than that. If you want to have a very lengthy number, unlimited number, then you have to go for long. But if you want to represent that a number is long, you have to suffix it with small l or capital L, like this, small l. Otherwise, capital L. Anything is allowed. Are you able to understand that? So this is long. When you just suffix means which comes after the value, then it is, what is that? Long, my dear friends. If you don't have anything as a suffix, then it is int. So this is having a limited base. This is having unlimited base. I hope this is clear now. Means unlimited length here, limited length here. So that is basic difference. You got clarity on this now? That's about integers. What is that? Integer is nothing but number without fraction. No fraction, no decimal. A whole number from minus infinity to plus infinity. But the point is, it can be represented in two ways, with L and without L. Difference is, if you don't use L, it is implicitly int. If you use L, it is implicitly, what is that? Long. I hope this is clear. Just remember, you don't need to have, what is that? Remember any data types here, but just have idea about the constants in Python. Then floating point constant. When you talk about this, it's always float actually, implicitly, or any float is float. What is that then? The point is very simple. A number with fraction, something like 10.5, 89.6, something like this. These are floating point constants. Decimals, I can say, what is that? I can say, these are decimal, friends. What is that? These are decimals. I hope this is clear. So, number with fraction is floating point, and implicitly, any floating point is float type. And these are the examples you can see here. I hope this is clear for all of you for clarity on this. And the other type is Boolean again. What is that? Boolean constants. See, when you talk about Boolean, we have just two Boolean constants. It's not like string. We can have unlimited strings. We can have unlimited integers. We can have unlimited decimals. But Boolean limited, just two numbers. Just two values, not numbers, I'm sorry. Just two values. One true, the other one is false. So Boolean is used to, Boolean is returned when you check a condition. When Boolean is returned, when you check a condition, Boolean is returned. So I'll talk more about that in operators, nothing to worry. So Boolean means, Boolean is nothing but it is returned when we check a condition. When we check a condition. So I hope this is clear now. Got clarity on this now? And we have two Boolean constants in Python. That is, first one is true and T must be uppercase. The second one is false, F must be uppercase. Because these are keywords and which is case sensitive in Python. Got clarity on this now? T must be uppercase, F must be uppercase. This is about Boolean constants. I hope this is clear for all of you. Got clarity on this now? And the last one, complex numbers. Might be you should have learned this in your school days, maybe in 10th class or intermediate if you are from MPC or if you are just a mathematical student. There is something called complex numbers, which is in the form A plus IB, something like this. Such numbers are complex numbers. You know, Python supports complex numbers. So, like, you know, for example, you can take an example like this. 10 plus I 20, something like this. Or 20 I, anything is fine. I can come before 20 or after 20, anything is fine for us. But that I is important because it has imaginary part also. A complex part has, complex number has two parts, a real part and imaginary. The first part is real, the second part is imaginary. We'll talk more about it in the upcoming sessions. But this is idea about what is that, complex numbers. I hope you got clarity about all the constants, all the basic constants, not everything in Python, but the basic constants in Python. Got clarity on this now? just close your eyes and summarize all the constants here. How many constants are there? String constants, which can be in single quotes or double quotes. Second one, numeric constants, integers and floating point. Integer without fraction, floating point with fraction. Third one, Boolean, just two values, true or false. And they are written when a condition is checked. And the last one is, what is that, friends? Last one is so simple. That is complex number, which is in the form of A plus IB. Generally, we had discussed, we know about complex in the, from school days. From where? From school days. I hope this is clear for all of you. Got clarity on this, sir? That's all about the basic constants of Python. In the next video, I'm going to explain about the advanced literals, which are useful in Python. I hope this is clean, right? Thank you very much for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe. And please share this video with your friends. And if you want to join my group, WhatsApp group, this is my number, 9493014078. And if you want any free workshops, even you can call me on this number so that I help you on this. Okay, when depends on the availability. Okay, thank you very much, friends. Thank you for watching this video. Let's keep watching.